We have been clear that all options remain on the table in the defense of our nation. But we do not seek, nor do we want, war with North Korea. As I said earlier this week, a sustained cessation of North Korea's threatening behavior must occur before talks can begin. North Korea must earn its way back to the table.
That was Secretary of State Rex Tillerson at the United Nations Security Council earlier today, calling on North Korea again to drop its nuclear ambitions and for our allies in the region to help contain that threat. This after Tillerson on Tuesday offered direct negotiations with North Korea if there was a pause in their missile testing. Meanwhile, Senator Lindsey Graham told The Atlantic this week there is a 70% chance President Trump would use the military option against North Korea if they conduct another nuclear test. They do that underground periodically. Those are not the missiles you see. That's an underground situation. Let's bring in John Bolton, former U.S. ambassador to the United Nations and a Fox News contributor. First of all, you know, I didn't miss the news this morning that the president and President Putin of Russia had been kind of exchanging some niceties back and forth. The same time you have Secretary Tillerson getting tough with China and Russia about North Korea. Bad cop, good cop?
Possibly. I think it's clear to everybody, time is growing short here before the United States is going to have to confront a really unhappy binary choice. Either we live with nuclear weapons in the possession of North Korea, or we have to look at the military option. So I think that's what Lindsey Graham is foretelling a little bit. I'm not going to second guess Lindsey on the odds, but the fact is it's greater than zero, which is what it was under Obama.
All right. You know, it's interesting today because as we look at where we are in terms of the testing that we're talking about, these are two different things than what we've seen. We're not talking about a ballistic missile. We mean those underground tests of nuclear testing. And, you know, Japan's foreign minister says they don't really want to meet with us. They don't want to talk about their nuclear program with us. That's not going to happen.
Well, that's why I was somewhat perplexed, I have to say, in the clip you just played of Secretary Tillerson.
Yeah, where's he getting that from?
Still talking about negotiating. We've talked to North Korea for 25 years. You want to talk to him some more? Be my guest. It's not going to have any
impact. But a one-on-one would be different than what we've done?
I don't think it would make any difference. In fact, if I were North Korea, I'd say, sure, I'd be happy to talk to the United States. You know why? Because then we'd sit there and do nothing while they cross the finish line and actually created deliverable nuclear weapons. So we're past the point where talking to North Korea is going to make any difference. Explaining to China and Russia that our threat of military force is serious, may produce a response. Mm-hmm. There's no evidence, unfortunately, that it's happened yet. And so I think Americans just have to make up their minds.
Are you
happy with this?
Why do we keep going back and forth on North Korea? You know, one week we're not going to talk to them, the next week we are. I mean, is there a bifurcation of policy within the administration?
Well, I think the State Department is still on autopilot with the policy it's been for about 25 years, which has failed miserably, which is to keep talking to North Korea. And honestly, the president's been pretty clear, reflecting reality, that it's not going to work. North Korea is not going to be chit-chatted out of its nuclear program this close to actually getting a delivery capability.
Are you worried if it comes to the military?
Well, I'm very worried about both options, frankly. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff said this summer, asked a question at Aspen. He said, it's certainly something to consider, to the use of military force. He said, what's unthinkable to me is leaving North Korea with nuclear weapons.